So while financials were underperforming throughout the entire year in 2007, before the market peaked, before the financial collapse, you can also see similar characteristics out of the components of the financial sector. Here, we're looking at Lehman Brothers. This is one of the oldest financial institutions ever in America. Here are the highs in the S&P 500 into the late 2007, plotted below. Up above, we have Lehman Brothers, L-E-H. Notice how with the higher highs in the S&P 500, Lehman Brothers was putting in lower highs. That bearish divergence is evidence of distribution, not accumulation. By the time the S&P 500 was already putting in its final high in October of 2007, Lehman Brothers was already putting in its third lower high. That evidence of distribution was a heads up that something was wrong. And sure enough, we had one of the most epic collapses in American bank history. Lehman Brothers no longer exists. But seeing that relative strength line diverge negatively would have given you plenty of opportunity to get out of Lehman Brothers well before it got to zero. We don't just buy stocks hoping that we're right. There needs to be something in between our price that we buy and zero, where we say, hey, you know what? Our thesis is wrong. We need to get out. And we'll talk about that more in the risk management section.